Thank you, Fungurumu. In the Katanga, we have a matrix of perhaps a young dolomite going around like that. Little bit of almost dendrites happening in there, most likely caused by heterogenite or heterogenite paintings in the young dolomite matrix. Sitting on the matrix would be a very young generation, well, chrysocolla, a very thin layer of chrysocolla, and covering the chrysocolla would be some druzy quartz crystals. Now, that would be the little white crystals, which have almost an undertone of bluishness, which is caused, of course, by the chrysocolla coming through. The crystals sitting on top of the chrysocollas would most likely be some vizinhierite or could be some heterogenite, so please look at my description. From a display point of view, what I find also quite interesting about this specimen is this section over here. It's almost a vuggy material, and the vugs are barren. So what's growing in those vugs, I see nothing forming. There was a deposit at a stage where I'd have little barite crystals forming in the vugs. In this case, I see nothing. So now, go around this way, so we could display it this way over too. It's actually funny, when I take the still pictures, depending on which angle I photograph the specimen at, some are clearer and some are not. So we have it at this angle, we have a certain look, and then we have it around at this angle. We have another look. I think in my collection I would display it with this up, because that to me is a rather interesting little section. I wonder if there is not some crystallization there. Well, let's assume in on that. There's something yellowish, perhaps even barite, maybe. All the way from the deposits of Tenke Fungurumu in the Katanga Copper Crescent in the Congo.